Dr Zakir, is the heir obliged to make up the fast of the one who dies before he makes up his obligatory fasts? And secondly, is a person allowed to fast for a person who's alive but is unable to fast due to some legitimate reason, maybe like sickness or such like?
All the scholars agree that if a person is alive, for example, and if he does not offer salah, no one else can offer on his behalf. Similarly, if a person misses any fast for any valid reason, he may be sick, or for example, he's continuously sick or is very old, so no one else can keep the fast on his behalf. As the Quran says in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 184, that if a person finds it difficult to keep the fast, then he should feed a poor person. He should feed an indigent person. So here, if a person is alive and if he cannot keep for a valid reason, like continuous sickness or old age, old man, old woman, then one person should be fed for every fast he or she misses. This is the ruling. As far as the first question is concerned, that if a person dies before you could make up for the fast that you're supposed to keep, so what is the ruling? Should the heir, should they fast on his behalf once he dies? As far as this ruling is concerned, there are two groups of scholars and the two opinions for it. As far as the ruling is concerned for this case, there are two opinions. One group of scholars, they say that the heir or the guardian, they should keep the fast of a person who has died and who ought to have fasted. Based on the hadith of Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 3, in the book of fasting, hadith number 1952, Hadith Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, she says that a person who has died, who ought to have fasted, then his guardians should fast on his behalf. So based on this hadith, the first group of scholars, they say that the guardian or the heir, they should make up for the fast when a person dies who ought to have fasted. But there's another group of scholars who say that that's not required, but a person should be fed on his behalf. Based on the hadith again of Hazrat Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, which is there in Muhalla Ibn Hazm, volume 4, page number 422, where Amra, may Allah be pleased with her, she asked Hazrat Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, that her mother had missed some of the fast during the month of Ramadan. So she asked Hazrat Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, that can she fast on behalf of her mother? So Hazrat Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, said that no, she should not fast on behalf of her mother, but she should give charity, equivalent to one sa that feeds a person for every fast that she has missed. So since both these two hadith contradict, the second group of scholars, what they say, the second opinion is that here it's specifically mentioned that the fasts that were missed were the fast of Ramadan. Whereas the first hadith of Sahih Bukhari, volume number 3, hadith number 1952, it's a general hadith saying that a person who died who ought to have fasted. So that's a general hadith, but this hadith is a specific hadith which says that these were the fasts that were missed due to Ramadan. And here the ruling is, according to Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, that the fast should not be made up, but one indigent person, one poor person should be fed. So since both the hadith cannot contradict, and both the hadiths are sahih, so the scholars, they say that if a person misses the fast of Ramadan, then the fasting need not be made up, but the right ruling is that one person should be fed who's poor. The other general hadith, they say, it indicates for a person who has vowed to fast. So if a person vows to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he or she will fast if certain wish is fulfilled, at that time, it's obligatory that the heir of the person who has died should make up the fast. And further, a similar thing is mentioned by Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him. It's mentioned in Sunan Abu Dawud, volume number 2, in the book of fasting, hadith number 2395, Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, he says that if a person dies who has missed his fast in Ramadan, then you should feed one poor person for every fast that he has missed. And you need not make up for the fast. There is no atonement for fast. But if a person has vowed to fast, if he has vowed that he will fast if some wish is fulfilled, then in that case, there is atonement of the fast, and that fast will be fulfilled by the heir or by the guardian. So based on these two hadith, because they do not contradict, that is the reason the opinion is divided, that if it's the fast of Ramadan which is missed, then the right ruling is that one person should be fed for every fast missed. Further, there's one more hadith in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 3, in the book of fasting, hadith number 1953, where it says, Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, he says that a person came to the Prophet and asked him that his mother had to make up for 1 month of fasting. So should he fast on her behalf? So the Prophet said, yes. He gave the answer in the affirmative. And it's good to make up the fast. But since again, this is a general hadith, it's not specifically mentioning whether it's the fast of Ramadan which is missed or whether it's the fast of vowing. And since we cannot agree that the Sahih hadith can contradict, so the best is the opinion, second opinion, that if a person misses any fast in the month of Ramadan, then one poor person should be fed on his behalf. But if a person vows and does not fulfill the fast, in this case, the fast should be made up by the heir.
Okay. Shukran.